we're heading in for the final day of CES for this year. Justin, what have been your highlights so far this week?
Yeah, thanks, Steve. I don't think we've seen any major product announcements that are truly groundbreaking. For me, the news was dominated by two individuals. In fact, on Monday, we had the rather dramatic meltdown of Michael Bay, the Hollywood film director, on stage. And we've seen the effect that that's had globally. You know, that has gone viral. They say there's no such thing as bad publicity for Samsung. And I think in this case, that's probably true. And then yesterday we had the launch of the T-Mobile's latest Un-carrier initiative. And of course, John Ledger, as he's traditionally does, he started mocking his competitors and really put them down.
AT&T is a total source of amusement for me because they're the one that takes my bullshit. Dumb move. They take the bait. And they talk in corporate speak.
I think it's been interesting how for a lot of the kind of companies such as sort of, I'm thinking Sony, maybe Samsung, even Yahoo, mobile is now sort of such a kind of integral part of their business that it doesn't really get broken out. You know, it's just kind of part of the bigger kind of picture. Is there anything else that's kind of grabbed you?
Yeah, I think the connected car market. This year compared to last year, you know, we've seen it really go up a gear, if you excuse the terrible pun. AT&T, we've seen three or four deals with major manufacturers around the connected car space. And we also saw the launch via Qualcomm of the new Formula E car.
Yeah, I mean, I think connected car's been one of the two biggest, the other being wearables. So I think we shall head in now to take a look at that.
Let's go.
So, Paul, the wearables market is getting a lot of attention here at the event. Yeah. I mean, what do you think is going to be important for a vendor to do to kind of succeed?
Yeah, well, from our perspective, we want to get digital health to more people. So we're very focused on changing the wearable space from just being about the device to really introducing a strong service component that can help people achieve their goals.
So I've been wearing a Fitbug all week. What do you think of my stats?
Well, bearing in mind it's only midday, 10,500 steps is not a bad start to the day. That's pretty good going.
So what have you announced here at the event?
The big thing that we've launched is a new program called Kick Plans. And the whole idea behind a Kick Plan is a 12-week program that is very goal specific.
So Tim, you've introduced your first commercial wearable products at the event. Can you talk us through what you've announced?
Yes, we're introducing two products. One, a sports tracking wristband called the LG Lifeband Touch, and a companion product called the Heart Rate Earphones. They can be used either individually or together.
Okay, can we talk a bit about the Lifeband Touch? I mean, what features has it got?
Well, the Lifeband Touch is a simple wristband that sits on your wrist, and it will track everyday movements like number of steps taken, calories burned, distance covered. But it also has a display, an OLED display, so that you can read your data on a real-time basis without syncing to an app. And since it's synced with Bluetooth to your smartphone, it can provide some useful information like caller ID when a text message or a call comes in.
Well, Qualcomm kicked off the week talking about how it intended to use its mobile heritage in related markets such as automotive and the home. Paul Jacobs also pointed out the opportunity that wearables will bring for the company.
Oh, I mean, I'm a huge believer in wearables because it's not just for things that people talk, you know, you talk about like the Fitbits and those kinds of things that are doing sort of wellness stuff. But the thing I actually have learned from wearing the talk is that it's all the notifications that I get. It's like created this sort of continuous interaction model for me.
It's been an interesting show because historically phones have been a big story here and some of the new devices, but actually it's shifted towards wearables. It's a wearables frenzy here. Smartwatches, things that go in your ears, things that you wear around your neck. So that's one big theme. Another one is curved screens, curved TVs everywhere, people thinking about how you have to develop content for that, but also a curved phone from LG, the LG Flex, which was announced in Korea and now is announced that will be coming to the US shortly.
So that wraps up our coverage of CES for this year then, boss.
It does, Steve. You know, and even with the crazy queues for the cabs and the monorails, we found some pretty innovative ways of getting about town and reporting all the news from this year.
So next stop, Mobile World Congress in Barcelona.
Indeed.